The Enchanted Tea Kettle. Long ago, in a beautiful temple on the outskirts of Kyoto, there lived a fat old priest who loved eating and drinking. After every meal, he did not feel satisfied until he had made a bowl of lovely, frothy green tea, using special teapots and bowls from his large collection. Once a week, he went into Kyoto to visit the antique shops, for it was there that he hoped to find more pieces for his collection. One day, he was searching for a new kettle in which to boil the water. And as he wandered down a little street he had never been down before, his eye caught sight of a little soot-covered kettle in the corner of a shop window. Although it was very dirty, his expert eye saw that it was an unusual one. He rushed into the shop and bought it immediately. The old shopkeeper was very happy to get rid of it, because it had been in his shop for so many years. The priest hurried home with the little kettle, eager to use it as soon as he could. But before he could do that, he had to sit down and polish it. It was so long since it had been polished, it took over an hour. But at last it shone in the firelight. It really was a beautiful thing, and the priest filled it with fresh well water and gently hung it over the fire. He watched lovingly as wisps of steam began to appear, and at last the water started bubbling. The priest quickly prepared his tea things and was about to take out some water when something very strange happened. First, a bushy tail appeared at one side of the little kettle. Then, four little furry legs under it. Then, a nose with long whiskers at the front. And finally, a pair of beady eyes and two pointed ears. The tea kettle had turned into a badger.
"Oh, oh!" it cried out. "How hot it is in here!"
And as the priest sat there speechless, its little legs kicked up the hot ashes in his face. It then leapt off the hook and started running around the room.
"Oh, oh! Please cool me down! Help, help!"
The priest was furious. He picked up a broom and chased the badger round and round the fireplace. Then the badger raced out through the sliding doors, across the veranda, and plunged into the temple pond outside. Hissing and steaming and frightening all the goldfish. When the priest pulled it out, it was just a little tea kettle again, and there was no sign of tail, feet, or whiskers. But the priest had been so angered by what had happened, he decided to throw it away at once and hurled it over the garden wall into the street. Just at that moment, a poor old rag and bone man was passing by wearily on his way home. He was amazed when the kettle flew out of the dark garden and landed with a clunk at his feet. He looked around, but there was no one to be seen. So he picked it up joyfully, put it on his cart, and hurried home. Now he too enjoyed drinking a good cup of tea, and he quickly gathered a pile of sticks and lit a fire under the little kettle. Suddenly, out popped the tail, then the legs, and then the head again. And this time the little voice shouted,
"Please put out the fire! I'm burning in here!"
Although the rag and bone man was amazed, he beat out the fire and stood back to look at the strange sight before him, half kettle and half badger.
"Oh, thank you, kind sir. That's the second time today I've nearly been cooked."
But,
began the rag and bone man.
"But what are you?"
"What am I? Why, I'm a magic kettle. That's what I am. And I haven't eaten for years. I'm starving. You wouldn't have any nice rice cakes here by any chance, would you?"
Now, it so happened that the Rag and Bone Man loved rice cakes. So he rushed into the kitchen and brought back a big box full of them. The badger munched through them happily, sighed contentedly, and wiped its whiskers with its tail.
Thank you very much. Thank you for saving my life. Now, what can I do for you in return?
Well, I don't know, really. I'm only a poor rag and bone man. I don't know any other life.
Said the badger.
Well, let me see. Ah, I know. I have a good idea. Tomorrow morning, I want you to put up a little tent in your backyard and then go round all your neighbours, telling them that there will be a special show in the afternoon. Sell as many tickets as you can.
The old man did just as the badger told him. The little tent went up, and he went round telling everyone to come round after lunch to see a mystery show.
But what you gonna do?
He asked the badger as they sat eating their lunch.
Don't you worry yourself about that. Just bang the drum when everybody's ready and leave it all to me.
So, all the neighbours, full of curiosity, came and paid their money. When the tent was full and everyone was sitting comfortably, the old man carried in the little kettle and put it on the wooden stage. Then he began to beat a drum. At first, nothing happened, and the people began to laugh. He beat the drum again. Still, nothing happened. One or two people were getting angry now because it looked as though the old man had tricked them. Then, suddenly, out popped the bushy tail, then the four little legs, then the whiskers, and finally the whole head. The badger rolled his eyes, waved his tail, turned a few somersaults, and the crowd began to clap. Then it sang a little folk song, danced a little dance, and whistled on a little whistle. Everyone was delighted. Then came the big moment. Slowly, the badger climbed up the rope ladder, two legs at a time, to the tightrope that stretched the length of the tent. The old man banged on his drum again. Everyone gasped as the badger lightly hopped along the rope, balancing an umbrella on its nose, holding a fan with its tail, and juggling rice balls with two paws. The audience clapped and clapped and shouted for more. But the old man told them that that was the end of the day's show and invited them back to another performance the next day. Then he took the badger by the paw and they had a meal of giant rice balls together. As the days went by, the badger show became more and more famous. The audiences got bigger and bigger, the rag and bone man richer and richer, and he and the badger happier and happier. But one night, as they were sitting by the fire, drinking a bowl of tea and counting their money, the man noticed that the badger was looking tired and his whiskers were turning grey.
Don't you think you ought to have a rest? After all, I've got quite enough money now to spend the rest of my life in comfort.
The badger thought for a moment and then said,
Well, as a matter of fact, I have been thinking about asking you if I could stop. I really enjoy the shows, but I do feel a bit shaky on the tightrope these days, and sometimes I nearly drop the rice balls. What I really dream of doing is going back to sleep for a few years inside the kettle.
Then how about living in a nice, quiet temple?
The old man suggested. The badger shuddered because he remembered what had happened before in a temple. The old man could see that he was worried and said,
No, don't worry. I've got a good friend who is a priest. He doesn't like tea at all. But I do know that he loves rice cakes. I'm sure you'll be happy there.
Oh, that sounds just my cup of tea,
cried the badger happily. So it was agreed on, and the priest kindly accepted the little kettle. He placed it in a respected position on a table in the cool treasure house of the temple. And every morning after prayers, he would place a little dish of rice cakes beside the tea kettle. And every evening after prayers, when he came to remove the dish, it was always empty. And where do you think the rice cakes went?